Hello there. Welcome to Gartex Electronics channel. Today I will show you how to make a 5 volts power supply circuit. In this video I will share my knowledge with you so that at the end of this tutorial you are able to design your power supply circuit according to your own requirements and specifications. Please remember to subscribe to this channel for more videos on electronics design, basic repairs and computer-based tutorials. In our previous tutorials, we learned basics on capacitors, diodes, how to identify the anode, positive, and cathode, negative poles of diodes. We also learned about resistors and light-emitting diodes. We will use the following components in our project. 1. A fuse, to protect the circuit. 2. The transformer. 3. The rectifier diodes. 4. The filter capacitor. 5. 5 voltage regulator IC. 6. An LED indicator. 7. Resistor. What is a transformer? A transformer is a device that is used to step up or step down the AC voltages, while keeping the input and out power the same. In our project we need a transformer that steps down voltage close to 5 volts. Converting AC voltage to DC voltage, remember the output voltage of the transformer is AC and not DC. So we need to convert the AC voltage to DC voltage using 4 rectifier diodes connected in series pairs or full wave bridge rectifier. Next, we filter the unstable or pulsating DC output from the rectifiers using a filter capacitor to remove ripples from the DC voltage. A voltage regulator is defined as the linear integrated circuit used to provide a regulated constant output voltage. Voltage regulation is very important in our project because we do not need a change in output voltage when the load changes. Step 1. Select the correct voltage regulator. In our project, we are designing a circuit for the 5 volts DC output voltage. We will select the LM7805 linear regulator IC. Step 2. The selection of transformer. Since the minimum input value to our regulator IC is 7 volts, we shall use a transformer of current rating 1 ampere and a secondary voltage of 6 volts. Step 3. The selection of diodes for the bridge rectifier. We select the IN4001 diode because it has a current rating of 1 ampere more than our desired rating, and a peak reverse voltage of 50 volts. What is peak reverse voltage? Peak reverse voltage is the voltage a diode can sustain when it is reverse biased. Step 4. The selection of smoothing capacitor. The capacitor which we gonna use for our design is 50 volts 470 microfarads. The output voltage of the diode bridge is a DC voltage consisting of ripples called pulsating DC voltage. This pulsating DC voltage can be filtered using a filter capacitor or a resistor capacitor coupled filter for removing the ripples. In our circuit, the filter capacitor stores energy as the input increases from zero voltage to a peak value, and when the supply voltage decreases from peak value to zero, capacitor starts discharging. This charging and discharging of the capacitor will make the pulsating DC become pure DC voltage. Note that, we are using a current limiting resistor, which is required for the LED, so that our LED doesn't burn up. Now let us do some connections. Connect the transformer to the bridge rectifier as shown in the figure below. Then connect the positive side of the bridge rectifier DC output to the positive side of the filter capacitor and the negative voltage to the negative of the capacitor. Next connect the voltage regulator, the current limiting resistor and LED as shown the figure below. Make sure that your circuit is properly soldered using a solder wire and a soldering iron. Always be careful when handling the 240 volts mains voltage because it can kill. Now test your circuit by connecting your transformer to the 240 volts mains. If your connections are good, the LED should be lighting. Thank you for watching. I hope you have learned something. Please like and subscribe for more electronic content. Bye.